And for more on how the markets are moving this morning, we're joined by Seth Denson, the co-founder and chief strategist over at GDP Advisors. Seth, really great to have you on this morning. Stocks jumping on partly on news that Janet Yellen is President-elect Biden's pick to run the Treasury Department. What specifically do investors like about it?
Well, I think what we're starting to see from what President-elect Biden is doing and what his administration might look like, I think to investors, it's like a warm, fuzzy blanket, right? I mean, with what the market has seen over the past 4 years, while positive from a perspective of where our economy has been and the regulatory structure and favorable tax structure, I think it's ready for a little bit of calm, cool, maybe some soft music by the beach, whatever, but some lack of volatility and some more consistency. And what Janet Yellen does is provides just that. Obviously, being a former Fed chair, she understands the market. She understands the correlation of what investors need to have in alignment with what the Fed can do. And so she brings that consistency, that steady voice that both Republicans and Democrats, I think, will like going into 2021.
For people who may not be familiar with Janet Yellen from her time at the Fed, what do you think her legacy is there?
Well, listen, she was one of those that, again, garnished respect from both sides of the aisle, which in today's political world, and while the Fed's not supposed to be political, let's be real, everything is these days, it's a hard thing to have. And so that respect, that steady aspect, she's fiscally conservative, and that's, again, the way that she approaches things is fiscal responsibility. But she's not afraid to borrow against the debt, especially when we have low interest rates. And so I think she brings a good balance of recognizing that, hey, we're going to need some stimulus here to get the economy going again into the early quarters of 2021. But she's going to have those deficit hawks on the right in a good place, recognizing she's not going to go too far.
Meanwhile, Fed Chair Jerome Powell, his term actually isn't up until February of 2022. Do you expect that Joe Biden will keep him?
Well, he certainly might, and I think it will depend a lot on how Yellen works with Powell going forward. Remember, these two have a history together already, so they've worked together at the Fed beforehand, so I would not be surprised to see a President Joe Biden extend Jerome Powell's time at the Fed. Again, assuming that everything is in alignment, we're still tracking in the right direction. Interestingly enough, the Fed is in a precarious position, though, because it's not like they can cut interest rates anymore. One thing that Janet Yellen did do in her term as Fed chair was slowly raise interest rates, not to scare off the market. And so it will be interesting to see in the first few quarters and maybe even in the first year of 2021 how those two can come together for the betterment of the country.
So we talked in the beginning just about all this positive vaccine news. It is incredible to see the markets where they are, basically near record highs. And coronavirus cases just exploding across this country, hospitals overflowing, deaths are going up again, unfortunately. Is there anything that could happen with the coronavirus in terms of the pandemic that would move the markets, or is it just tunnel vision right now until the vaccine gets out?
Well, I think there's two things to keep in mind here. First and foremost is that the markets are really throwing the ball where the receiver will be, not necessarily where the receiver is, to bring in a Tuesday morning quarterback analogy there. And so the foundational structure that we have in our economy was one pre-pandemic that many of us were saying that if we can get things on the right track quickly, we would see a very V-shaped like recovery. And I think that the markets are showing that we are seeing that. Now, what could go wrong? Well, something could go wrong with these vaccines, right? They don't get widely distributed. We have issues getting them into the people's hands. We have issues getting people to want to take them. I think that that could be something that shifts things the wrong direction. But all indicators are positive. Now that we have three drug makers are ready to go, this is all positive news, and I think the markets are reacting appropriately.
All right, Seth Denson, co-founder and chief strategist over at GDP Advisors. Great to have you on this morning. Appreciate it.